All right, there's how it's shaping up for the race for governor that's already been called and decided. Greg Abbott is the next governor of the state of Texas, currently attorney general, has beaten Wendy Davis solidly tonight, and she's called and conceded. We've heard her give her concession speech tonight from her Fort Worth headquarters. We expect Greg Abbott to be speaking just after 10 o'clock in time for all of the beginning of all the 10 o'clock news statewide to proclaim victory and maybe outline some of his plans. So that is where it stands right now on the race for governor and the direction of Texas politics with the Republican governor.
And you'll see the governor-elect make his victory speech right here live on Fox 4. But right now, let's get you to Heather Hayes and Jason Villalba for Jason's take on the results so far.
Well, let me tell you, so far we've had an interesting discussion going on over here. Jason, you're going to be with us throughout the night. Of course,
I will.
We appreciate you being here. Let's go right to Wendy Davis. This number, this 39%, what does that say to you?
Well, Senator Davis gave a very gracious speech to Abbott, but there's no question that the 20% margin that you're seeing here is a takedown of epic proportions. I think the people of Texas have spoken. They've spoken very firmly, and they want Republican control of the state. This is a much bigger margin than we anticipated. The polls were only showing 17%,
right?
But he wins by 20 points. So consider this.
Okay.
39 points is what she was able to get. Bill White, as Steve pointed out, got 42%.
Right.
So that's the threshold that she was looking for. Battleground Texas comes in. All of Obama's operatives, tens of millions of dollars, effort on the ground, people walking all over the state, and they didn't move the needle forward. Moved it backwards.
Do you really think they moved it back, going from that 42 then to the 39?
They went from 42 to 39, a 3% drop. What does that tell you? That tells you that the story for tonight is that Battleground Texas should head back to Washington with their tail between their legs and get out of Texas, because we are a Republican state.
But you kept hearing Wendy Davis say it, we won, we won, in her very gracious speech that she gave tonight. So she's trying to stay positive, but let's look at this race. And the numbers here, Dan Patrick, 59 to Leticia Vandeput, 39.
So this tells us a compelling story as well. Leticia Vandeput was supposed to be a stronger candidate than Wendy Davis. And Patrick had some early problems in the early primary. But what this tells us, that he is equally strong as Abbott. He will continue to be strong going forward. This also tells us that the robust right, some call it the Tea Party, some call it the Liberty Movement, is just as strong as the establishment movement in Texas. Patrick is very strong going into his lieutenant governor position, and I think it bodes well for his future politically.
All right, so do you think he's going to be able to get things done in the state? I mean, because he is so ultra-conservative, is there going to be a meet in the middle sort of?
Well,
sort
I
of
think what this margin tells you is that the people are speaking. They want conservative leadership from Dan Patrick and from Greg Abbott. You're going to see it in this legislative session. We're looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to working with Senator Patrick, or now Governor Patrick, and then Governor Abbott. It's going to be a fantastic time in Texas. We're going to see some wonderful things happen.
All right, and we're going to continue this discussion right here as the evening continues and more numbers start coming in. Jason, thank you.
Thank you.